What is going on, guys? It's your boy Seso here. Bring us a Photoshop tour to make your own mockups or templates or presets. You know, if you guys don't really know what mockups are, I'll just give you a brief explanation of what they are in my, you know, head. Basically, they're templates of just maybe some, like, I have an example here of a business card or some kind of card or whatever. And I just like to give your clients or whoever you're working for a really nice, like, a showcase of what the product that you made them, which whether it be a logo or a design of a card or something, and show it on, like, you know, on a real life scale, I guess you can say. You know, like, there's mockups out there that have, like, you know, 3D little features to it. If you use, like, the actions of in Photoshop, there's Photoshop actions that actually make things 3D as well. I don't really know how to do all that, but you can also Google that into and get all into it if you want. But otherwise, I'm just showing how to use the feature, you know, smart object, which is simply all you do is right click on a new layer or whatever, and it says convert to smart object. Most like any, like, you know, stock image, if you're using any stock images, you know, off Google or something, you get on images. Actually, they are already in smart object, you know, form. And that's just, if you see a little page thing right here, let me just do it for this right here. You see this little page, and that means this is a smart object right now, which means that, you know, it keeps, like, smart object is a lot of things. When you double click on it, if you have, like, if this is a text, like, it isn't, but it's just, if I were to double click on this, it'll open up a new document. I'll show you an example in a second, but I'm just saying, if you open up this, it'll open up a new document, you can actually change the text, and then when you close it and save it, it will actually be, you know, whatever, this is a text, and it'll just change it. I don't know if you guys will get that until I actually show you. So anyways, I'm just going to quickly show you what I mean by an example. I have, like, a simple mockup here. You can actually download below in the description to play with it if you don't know what mockups are. I'm going to be teaching you how to use them as well, because sometimes people just get confused on how to use them. So I'm just going to quickly go into the card right here, and I have the main card. And you see what I mean, right? Like, it's going to, most mockups just have this, like, just basically the layer here with this little page thing. What this means is you double click on it, it's going to ask you editing, you know, context, blah, blah, blah. Just press OK. And you can also press do not continue if you don't want to. But you can see over here, it actually has all the stuff that I have on this card in, like, edited form. So actually, this allows it to hide all this little editing stuff that I did on the card itself, put it in smart object, so I can open up a new layer and mess around with it. I'm just going to quickly just change this to, like, change it to a red or something. I have no clue. Just to show you what I mean, I'm going to change it to red. Oops, I'm going to change this to red. Alright, so that's what it is. Let's just say if this is the coolest design you've ever seen in your life. And now I said if I close it, and before I close it, press save or just press control S. Just press yes. And then when you close it down, and you go back to your original, you know, your original mockup right here, it actually changes all the stuff in here as well. That's just by using smart objects. So it's a really, really cool, you know, technique or whatever, or a really cool, like, just a new form of, if you don't know what it actually is, and actually how to use them as well. So I'm going to teach you how to use them like I just did. And show you how to, you know, make your own if you want. I'm just going to make the card again like I did before. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to simply just uncheck this one and make a new layer really quickly. And you don't have to really follow the tutorial on how to make, you know, if you want to actually learn how to make a business card mockup, then this is for you. But if you just want to learn how to do it, you just stay tuned for a little second. I'm just going to design a simple, you know, business card stack and stuff. So what I'm going to do, I'm using the rectangle marquee tool on a new layer. I'm just going to quickly just go like this. Actually, no. What you got to do is... you go to your file, new, and you know, for things, you're gonna probably have to do file new and then actually find the width and height or whatever to the pixels or in inches. In business cards, they are actually 3.5 by 2. This is basically your US, you know, standard, you know, dimensions for business cards. If you're doing like a computer screen, maybe you do like a 1280 by 720p, or and then when you wanna put it inside a mockup, you probably do a 1920 by 1080p. Just so you can actually see, like, I don't know if I can really explain it the way, like, unless I just show you. But anyway, let's get focused on what we were doing before. And like I said, I'm going to do a card. Open it up. So what you do is when you open this up, you can actually just drag it with the movement tool. Just drag it right in here. And, oops, didn't mean to do that. Hold on. File, new. Resolution should be 50, not 300. Quickly. My bad. But anyways, once you do this, you just drag it right into your new, you know, mock-up right here. And what this will do is just basically give you like a nice blank, you know, you're basically your regular card, blank card. So what you do is right when you put it in, anything you put in, I have another example here really quickly to show you, anything you put inside, like before you actually edit it, you probably want to make it, you want to make it to a smart object so it like basically just takes all the information that you did to it. So if you put another thing in it, it'll actually take that, you know, those effects and all that other cool stuff. So anyways, I'm gonna show you this example really quick before I go back to here so I can actually, you know, take your mind and like what I'm trying to talk about. I'm trying to like really focus really hard and like explain it right, but it's just really freaking cool. And anyways, I've just dropped down this really quickly, double click on this to change the logo, press OK. I already have this for tutorial purposes, the Twitter logo right here. Press Control S like I said before for the shortcut. And if I go back to here, it will actually now have the Twitter logo as the basically the focus logo. And you actually change the example text right here as well, because I have this on in edited form with, you know, the right click convert to smart object as well. And this is just how I told you before. I just want to make sure you guys know that as soon as you put something inside, you want to make it to a smart object if you're going to do anything with it, like change perspectives or even add effects to it. So before you do all that, make sure you convert it to a smart object. So now what you want to do, which is basically, you know, just give it like a new cool little perspective or something. I'm just going to go like this and then kind of right click, distort, kind of like mess around with it, right? And let's just say that's a cool perspective for, you know, tutorial purposes. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to double click on this really quickly. And it's like I said, I'm just going to make it like a complete just random business card stack. Put a nice drop shadow on it. The spread up a little bit. Size up a little bit as well. And I probably do a way better job in like kind of like trying to match the background I have here that I got from Google or whatever. Like a cool little wooden table background. I probably match the perspective more, but for tutorial purposes, I'm trying to hurry this up. And I'm just going to write Control J. Move it up a little bit. Control J as well to make another duplicate. Move it up a little bit. Control T for the free transform. Trying to like turn it a little bit. Give it a little of a different, you know, thingy right here. And I'm going to press one more. Control J. Just make another stack, but actually make this one basically more to the left or whatever, more to the right. And I just give that one the main focus of that's where the you can actually see the full design, except for everything being hidden below the other cards. So what I'm going to do now, simply just move it to the middle or something. And I'm going to group this all together. And these are the back cards, so I'm just going to just name it back or something. And this is the main card. So what I do is when I want to edit this now that I have this like cool, you know, feature with the smart object, I double click on it, press OK. And let's just say you just want to drag this client's logo that they actually put or actually made for them. And they want to see like it on business cards and or like, you know, magazines. You actually make more, you know, magazine mockups if you want to make a magazine in Photoshop and then use its pages and like, you know, take the pages and actually crop them out and maybe give that page the smart objects to actually change it when you want to put other designs into it. Like I said, it's probably like difficult for me to like, you know, actually, you know, how can I teach you that, but I can, you can for sure explore it and you will figure it out as soon as you like, you know, like explore with Photoshop and be like, yo, this is what smart object is. Now I know what this does and I have to like actually keep on freaking undoing it or something like that. You know what I mean? It just gives you the idea and actually gives you more knowledge in Photoshop itself. So that's what my tutorial is really about. And actually how to use mockups as well, besides also if you want to create your own, how to basically do it. And so like I said, I put a cool little design here, and then once I do that, I can just press Control S or close it down and press save, and then I go back to here, they will now have my logo on it. So it's actually very, very simple, and it's just really unique for you as well. If you ever want to like make a marketplace for maybe mockups or something and actually do things like this, like having a cool little, basically a showcase for logos for your, you know, clients or something, if you want to give them like a cool, a picture with like a really nice texture in the background or a nice gold texture, foil, whatever, you know, some, just think about stuff like that when you want to do mockups. You can look in way more into it. Like I said, there's more actions in Photoshop. You actually do an action that makes up 3D, and I can just do some 3D features in Photoshop, etc., etc. This is just more of a basic tutorial, and so hopefully you guys actually caught what I said there. If you didn't, I'm sorry, but I just want to get through it because there's a lot to talk about, and actually, you know, just want to show you guys what creating a smart object is and what it can do. So hopefully you guys enjoy the tutorial. And actually, before I go, I can actually show you how to do something like this. Very, very simple. So what I'm going to do is just going to drag my logo in here really quick. Like I said, when I want to make a mock-up or something, as soon as I put whatever the object I want to mock up, I'm just going to size this down a little bit. And whatever, before I want to do anything or change the perspective, put effects on it, I want to right-click, convert to smart object, Control-T. I'm going to mess around with it a little bit, give it a nice cool... you know, distort it in perspective a little bit, and there we go. So I'm gonna just, you know, right click. I have a regular old paste layered already effects already done, and what I do is just take my background that I use for the basically the backing of it, duplicate it, put it above the new logo or the text or whatever I want to make, you know, a mockup of. Right click, convert clipping mask it. And now you have this cool little, you know, basically logo with a cool background or texture on it with a background behind it as well. I could probably like make the inner shadow way more better and stuff. I'm just like I'm saying, just for tutorial purposes, I'm just trying to like cover this up. And, you know, something like this or whatever, make it darker. But let's say you wanted to sell this and you had a really cool, sweet, like, background or whatever, and you had a cool logo for it. So people want to sell this, and maybe it'll be if you want to put your logo on it and have this cool little background, or just want to sell it for other people who want to showcase their logos with this, you know, quote unquote template or mockup. They can just double click on this as easy as possible. As easy as possible, really. They can just double click on it, really easy. Press OK. And we're just going to take, I don't know, where's that Twitter logo? Yeah, we're going to take this Twitter logo really quickly, pop it in here, like so, place it in the middle, and Control S. And then once you go back, you actually see now the logo is now the Twitter logo. So it's very, very simple to do. And that's how I did that other one I did before, like I showed you before, like this one right here. So yeah, hopefully you guys really enjoyed the tour. Like I said before, if you probably didn't catch anything, I'll probably do a little step-by-step thing in the description below. So if you want to look below there, so you can just basically get a better idea. And yeah, so hopefully you guys follow me on Twitter at SesoHQ. Like the video if you guys really enjoyed it. 200 likes in this video equals the secret giveaway description below. How do I mess up my outro like that? Jeez. Anyways, SesoHQ out. Peace. Hope you guys enjoyed.